college students of Reddit. What is the stupidest question you have heard another student ask a professor? During a third year aerospace engineering class on aircraft design, if an aircraft falls apart during flight, is that bad for the pilot? Well, yeah, I mean, he could lose his job. Tutor, this module is worth 60% of your overall grade. Student, 60% of what? Tutor, pause, 100. In mass communications class, a girl asked the teacher, do dogs have organs? It was totally random and had nothing to do with the radio broadcasting. So all 435 representatives live in one house. Suddenly, I have an idea for a reality TV show. Why don't the terrorist countries have to follow the constitution? This sounds like something a 7-year-old would say. Comma, if we have weapons that can blow up the entire world, how come no one has used them? This person also began an essay with the following. Comma, chess, checkers, Russian roulette. These games are played by millions each day, all over the world. I'm going to find a course where chess, checkers, Russian roulette could be an appropriate essay title. Oh, I'm gonna have fun with this. If China is ahead of us by like a day, why didn't they warn us about 9/11? God dang freedom-hating communists. Prof, Russia has had difficulty in dismantling their nuclear stockpile. Student, why don't they just aim them up? Prof, I'm sorry. Student, point the missiles up, shoot them, then blow them up in the sky. This wasn't a question, but by far the dumbest statement I have ever heard made to a professor. Our black professor was talking about some book we were reading and referred to the main character as a black person. This girl puts her hand up and says, excuse me professor so and so, but they prefer the term colored people. He just stared at her and quietly said, oh honey, no no number. This reminds me of a time a girl was very upset while we were talking about black Europeans. She calmly told us that they prefer African Americans. She could not wrap her head around why that was not correct. In my early morning geography class, we were looking at some world maps on the board discussing World War II when a student raises his hand and asks what's on the other side of the world, since the map only shows half. As if no one had explored the other side of the world, like the dark side of the moon. No one laughed or said anything, we just ignored it entirely. We don't mention the dark side of the earth in polite company. In a geography course in my third year of university, a friend of mine asked near the end of a lecture on the greenhouse effect, which he wasn't being 100% attentive in, why wouldn't they just stop building greenhouses? We will never let her live that down. We were doing an autopsy in pathology class, and the professor told us to write down any visible abnormalities before starting to dissect the cadaver. One girl suggested conjoined ball sacs as an abnormality, because the person only had one large ball sac and not individual ones for each testicle. The professor thought she was joking. She was not. I remind you, this is in 3rd year of med school. This girl has managed to pass anatomy, physiology and many other classes related to male anatomy. I really hope she wrote conjoined ball sacs in her lab report. Girl in my class didn't understand why airplanes' windows won't go down. Also, same girl, same class, thought you could die from being a virgin. Thankfully that nice high school boy was willing to save her life. Guy in my intro psych class. Guy, I like to go hiking, and whenever I get hungry I just put some dirt in my mouth and I'm not hungry anymore. Why is that? Professor, that's very interesting. Rice grows in fields? I thought it was made from chipped potatoes. Do you have to pass college to get a college degree? He thought you could just get in and that was enough. Well, when you come to college to play sports, the college part gets confusing. Communications teacher introduces herself as Dr. Tafer, tells us about her doctoral dissertation she spent a ridiculous amount of time and effort on. Someone asked what kind of surgeries she performed in grad school. When reading Lord of the Flies, a girl in my class asked, oh come on, if they're so thirsty, why don't they just drink the ocean? I'm currently teaching Lord of the Flies, and found out today that some of the students have decided to get back at a girl who talks constantly by just making up plot points. She currently thinks that they will find a jeep in the next chapter, ride it over some shallow water to a neighboring island, and find a speedboat there that they will ride home. In my database programming class, what's a left click? There were two technology prerequisites that the student had to pass in order to be in that class. I have no idea how they made it. Discussing influences on early industrial fabric production in Europe, particularly the influences of cloth and color in India. Wait, they have cloth in India? She was, for the rest of our time in college, known as "There's No Cloth in India Girl." A girl in one of my classes held her hand up while the professor went over the rules of our true or false quiz. The teacher finally called on her and said hers would be the only question before the exam. Girl, so the answers could be true or false? Professor, yes. Fasapum. First year world history, spent 4 lectures discussing the Crusades. Student 1, so did the Crusades have anything to do with religion? Student 2, no, because the Pope wasn't invented yet. No one corrected either of them. Why do you care if we plagiarize? It's not like it hurts anyone. Can't you mind your own business? What makes it better or worse is that he was actually a middle-aged dude with kids, not some fresh out of high school kid. Astounding. Excuse me, professor. I don't really see how that's possible. Millions of Jews? Why didn't they just fight back? That's just not true. This is sadly a common belief. I have heard this multiple times from random people. This kid in my intro bio class freshman year first semester, he was a douche. Chose to talk and crap during class and never did his work. We had a case study to turn in at the halfway point of the year on a pharmaceutical drug of our choosing. He shows up on the due day with nothing. He raises his hand right when the prof walks in and says, "And I crap you not, this is true. I have a note from my mom. Can I get an extension in front of the entire 300 person class?" Professor responds, "No son, you cannot. Your mom cannot save you. This is not high school." I think the kid actually dropped out of school the next semester for flunking all of his courses. If I asked my mom to write a note like that, she would kick my ass for being such a lazy butthole. That kid is spoiled. But doesn't the sun revolve around the earth? I was actually asked this question during a primary science unit for a primary education bachelor's degree. I was asked to help explain how to demonstrate the phases of the moon using the shoebox and torch method. As I was talking about how, one of the other students in my class dropped this on me. The whole class went silent, and I was standing there not knowing what to say. Thankfully, the tutor professor broke in and explained that she had an Earth-centric view. This girl was in her third year of an education degree. I imagine Galileo was spinning in his grave. Girl in philosophy class, can I ask a rhetorical question? A woman in my midterm class, who had had a hysterectomy, asked if the uterus was part of the urinary system. She asked several idiotic questions throughout the semester, but that one was the worst. It was physically painful to be in class with her. I was rather shocked to see her at graduation. She wasn't very bright, and she was incredibly self-centered and rude to both students and instructors. She was even caught cheating in a different class I had with her. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but something is up with her passing and graduating. If a bear and a deer were the last things on earth, would they mate? I'm not even joking. A girl asked that. Prof, no calculator is allowed on the test. Student, can I use the calculator app on my phone? A girl in my high school asked if she could take her math exam outside because her calculator had those solar power panel things. Do you really think you can fail ME through book and awaited response? Security called. Student removed from class. Professor, this isn't high school anymore, people. Whining and outbursts get you nowhere. They shouldn't get you anywhere in high school, either. In a music theory class, we had this kid who, when the professor explained something, would raise his hand, repeat the information in the form of a question, and then add just to clarify, every, dang, time. Teacher, if you drink methanol you will die. Girl in class, so, if you drink that at a party, the next morning when you wake up will you be dead? While talking about cancer and tumor formation midway through my microbiology class, this middle-aged dude who always carried around a rolling suitcase, and I mean luggage-sized, raises his hand and says we can eradicate it. Everyone knows the cure already exists, but there's too much money in it for big medical. My prof happily says I think you might be confusing it with another illness. Because I'll admit that there are plenty out there that could be eradicated by now, But cancer is your own tissue mutating and launches into a whole explanation that was very well done. Everyone was taking notes, she was on her A game. It was an excellent presentation. After she's done, he shakes his head and starts asking my friend and I how can you believe these lies my prof is and tells him they're not lies, they're biological facts. He then stands up, opens his luggage, and starts pulling file folder after file folder out, saying it's evidence his organization has gathered that proves it's all lies. My prof says, look, you're obviously very passionate but you're taking up a lot of class time. Come see me after. I can discuss this with you during office hours. This throws him into a rage. He tosses everything back into his luggage, looks up at her and says, how can you feed these lies? How can you feed this filth? It's people like you, the sick people, the evil people, holding us all down all the while, getting redder and redder in the face and stepping closer and closer to her, and he points and yells. She tells him to get out, or she's calling security. He says, do your worst, Satan's dong sucker. We will all fight against your lies, and we will win. And then turns around, casually picks up his things, and walks out of the room like nothing happened. Only saw him again at the final. Professor, can anyone name a natural hazard? Student, fog. Professor, good. And why would that be a hazard? Student, because you can choke on it and then drown in it. I don't even. If H2O is water, is H202 mist? This was in Chem 2, which means this person got through a Chem I. Why do we need any more engineers? All of the bridges are already built. Someone's gotta run them trains. I was sitting behind this girl who had been previously giving the professor a hard time about how she couldn't wear her headphones in class. The professor was firm on her policy and still the girl wouldn't take her headphones out. Later in the lecture she then asked the professor to slow down and speak louder because she couldn't hear, with her headphones still in. Discussing equal opportunity rights for women in a human resources class, and the subject of women recently being allowed in combat. One guy pops up with, but can they still have babies if they get shot? WTF. Teacher stares at him for a second and uncomfortably said, well, I guess that depends where they were shot and how badly wounded. He then directed the comments back into a normal discussion of equality. In junior year of college, I was with a class in an anatomy lab looking at very dead, very naked, and very obviously male body. We were going over the body and we got to the lower half, where the deceased's twig and berries were prominently on display. The dim bulb of our group seized on a moment of silence to point to the man's genitals and ask the professor, are those the ovaries? He was dumbstruck while the rest of us tried to contain laughter, but we all lost it when he said, number, that is their penis, in his matter-of-fact German accent, and she just said ooh and wrote it down in her notebook. I thought butter came from trees, you're telling me it came from an animal? Did Albert Einstein invent electricity, or did he just discover it? She didn't ask the professor, but I overheard a girl in class ask her friend how they put silk in the silk soy milk, and why you couldn't taste it. Girl I had freshman history with, professor, so who can tell me about Pearl Harbor? Girl, oh my god, I love that movie. Turns out she didn't know the movie was based on a real life attack on Hawaii. Also disconcerting that she not only liked it but loved it. I hate when students ask questions about personal family related problems while in class. Professor, some patients with colon cancer will notice blood in their stools. Student, my uncle had blood in his stool last week, but the doctor told him it was hemorrhoids. Do you think he has cancer? I wish the professor would ask these students, did I see his anus myself? You have been visited by the dinner doggo. Good and also tasty stir fries will come to you if you comment thanks for the recipe. Dinner doggo, if you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.